Out of the swimming pool. standing on this big cement area next to the swimming pool, and I literally watched the concrete make a wave. The beams like a wave. Things crack, of course, but sometimes things just do all kinds of stuff that they're not supposed to do. And I think Matthew is very smart to say that that's kind of like what happens on the morning when Jesus is risen. Somehow or other, something happens that everything that is solid moves and changes. Everything we understand about the way life works is a little different. Or a whole lot different after this morning. And we know that there is a kind of life that you and I have that is not just counted by birth days and numbers of years, but that is eternal, which doesn't mean it lasts a long, 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 long time. It means it's somehow something out of time, beyond time. So hard to comprehend, and yet that is who we have been created to be and who God makes us in the blessing of the resurrection. So, how are we going to be different after this morning? What do you do after you see the earth move in funny directions and you know that life is not what you thought it was? Well, what Jesus says, of course, is you love. Because it's the love that makes it all happen. It is God's grace and love that makes for eternity, for something out of time. The other thing you can do, of course, and I've said this to you all many times before, and I've said it to the rest of you even more, is pray. Is to connect with God. The way the Colossians is going to say it this morning is they're going to say, if you have been raised in Christ, then live in things that are from above. And the way to get there is to always remember that deeper, truer love. Even when you're angry, even when you're hurt, and especially when someone else is angry or hurt and you need to be there for them. And to be able to live out of something so much bigger and more beautiful than whatever bad stuff comes our way. All right, before you all go, why don't you all start showing people how to flower that crop? And then if anybody else wants to come up and take part in that, they can. Now, if the rest of you would please stand if you're able. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of all hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit. through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter began to speak to them. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear. Not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed is Psalm 118. We will read it responsibly by the whole verse. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Let Israel now proclaim, his mercy endures forever.
The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation.
There is a sound of exultation and victory in the tents of our righteousness.
The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed.
I shall not bow but live and declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord has punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death.
Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them. I will offer thanks to the Lord.
This is the gate of the Lord. He who is righteous may enter.
I will give thanks to you, for you answered me, and have become my salvation.
The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
On this day, the Lord is active. We will rejoice and be glad. A reading from the Epistle to the Colossians. If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. As the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised. As he said, come see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. And indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of Christ.
Took
Show us that the life God gives us is for all time, beyond time, past our comprehension, past our time, and yet incarnate, real. So in the weeks ahead, we'll hear stories of Jesus eating and cooking fish. Show Thomas the holes in his hand and say, just put your fingers right here and know. The truth is, we don't have that kind of body of Christ right here to put our fingers in and know, but we have our own bodies. We have the body of all creation. We have the bodies of those around us. And the truth is,
what he means in Hebrew. And we live differently. We see with new eyes. We know that life is something much more than what we so often imagine. God shows us the way. So let us sing hallelujah.
We pray for those serving our armed forces and in our diplomatic corps.
God of unchangeable power and the eternal life. Look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery. By the effectual working of your providence, carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation, that the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up. Things which have grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by Him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Yeah. hired for the Celtic service on the back there. Some of you have, in the past, when you go by the post office, hung one on the post office bulletin board. If you have another place for one, take them and spread the news so we can have as many people as possible for that. And if you've ever gone to Shrinehop, you need to try it at least once. It's a glorious place up on the side of the mountain. We have some birthdays to celebrate this week. So Alan May is on the 11th. Mary Ann Gilbert is on the 14th. And Trish Reed is on the 13th. Pray for all of them, but Alan is right here. Watch over your children, O Lord,
as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged and sorrowful. And raise them up when they fall. And in their hearts, in your peace, which passes understanding, abide all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing.
Amen.
sacrifice for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you
have graciously accepted us.
Thank you.